who declined the offer, but he did pay $50,000 to a former top Trump campaign advisor for help in his quest to secure a pardon. Well, to talk more about the pardon system, we are joined by John Kiriakou himself, who is still seeking a pardon. Kiriakou served 23 months in prison after he exposed the CIA's torture program. John Kiriakou, welcome back to Democracy Now! Before we get your response to these pardons, tell your own story, your own attempt to get a pardon and what it involved.
It was different under Donald Trump than it was certainly under Barack Obama. The normal way of applying for a pardon is you simply go online to the website of the Office of the U.S. Pardon Attorney. You fill out the form. It then goes to the FBI, which does an investigation, and then the pardon attorney makes a recommendation of yes or no. That's the way it's supposed to work. The way it worked under Donald Trump is that he ignored the Office of the U.S. Pardon Attorney. In most cases, the pardon attorney wasn't even consulted. If you were a friend of the president, or you knew someone who was a friend of the president, or you hired a friend of the president, and you could get to him and make your case, then you were considered for a pardon. What I did was I had to hire a lobbyist who had headed the Trump campaign in Florida in 2016. She charged me $50,000 that I didn't have. I had to borrow with a promise of another $50,000 once I got the pardon. The money went down the drain. But we now know that that other associates of Donald Trump were charging double that, even 10 and 20 times that.